Hello friends, namaskar. I'm Kanchan Sharma from Impact Learning Classes. Today we are going to discuss about what herbarium is. In our BSc Part 3, we have a paper in botany named as Plant Taxonomy and Classification of Angiosperm. For that purpose, a student need to make the herbarium file record. And today we are going to discuss how to make it. As students are at home, how they can make it. So this video is for your assistance and to guide you that how you are going to make a herbarium record for yourself. So first of all, we would like to discuss what herbarium is. So basically, herbarium is a dried and a pressed form of plant that you study throughout the year from angiosperms. Or you can make a herbaria of any plant kingdom plants. Like you can make a herbaria of algae or fungi. And today I'm going to discuss about the plants of angiosperms. So herbarium's definition I have written here on the board. Herbarium is collection of preserved plant specimens which are dried and pressed in the dried and pressed form. So we'll be drying the plants and we'll be pressing it with the help of plant press, and I'll be telling you the substitutes also for that purpose. And it is known as herbaria. And the sheets are arranged in accordance with any accepted system of classification. Like there are system of classification in botany. For angiosperm, we follow Angler and Prandtl's classification system as well as Bentham and Hooker's classification system. And in India, we follow Bentham and Hooker's classification system. So we will arrange the herbaria as per the accordance of Bentham and Hooker's classification system. Fine. So what we'll have to do, we'll have to collect the plants. And we need to press them, we need to dry them, and we need to paste all of them on the herbarium sheets. Fine. So what are the equipment required to make a herbarium record? Here they all are. First of all, you need to make a complete list of the plant that you are going to collect. For that, you need to go through the syllabus, and as per your syllabus, you need to write down the name, as vernacular name as well as the botanical name of the plant. You need to identify them, that which plant is this. Like if I am telling about Azadirachta directa indica, it is neem in common language. So you should know what neem tree is, how does it look. So you need to identify it properly. Then you will be going in a botanical garden. If you can't go there, you can go in any nearby garden, in any local garden, in any plant nursery, and you can collect the plant from there. For the collection of plant, we need all these equipments like trowel, notebook, scaturator, then vasculum, plant press, and the sheets. Trowel is basically a khurpi, you can say in Hindi. With the help of it, you can dig the plant. It is a digger, and you can dig the plant. Like there are some small plant, for example, Euphorbia hitta. It is very small in size, as well as so many small plant like Cynodon dactylon, that is dhoop ghas. It is also very small in size. So such kind of a small plant, you need to take them intact. You need to take them with their root also. So you need to uproot such kind of plant. But if you are taking a sample from a tree, then you will have to make ensure that you are taking floral part as well as leaf and stem portion. So it will be like this. I will show you. Like this is a plant, Amaranthus. Here is one more plant. This is purple heart plant or Tradescantia. And here I have taken tulsi. So in tulsi I have these inflorescence also, stem portion and leaf portion. In Tradescantia I am having leaves and stem portion. And you should take a portion which is carrying flower in it. Basically you will have to take it like that only. So after collecting the plant, what we'll be requiring a notebook. You can take any pocket size notebook, and in which you will have to mention that on which date, in which climate, and where, in which locality you have collected this plant. Fine. And in which condition it was. Is it herbaceous? Is it annual plant? Is it a perennial plant? Is it a tree or whatever? And in which habit it was grown, like from where you have collected it. You need to mention all those things in your pocket diary. Then you will have to you will be requiring scissors also and cutters also to cut the section of the plant, and after that we need to collect it. So as per the norms of making proper herbaria, we will be requiring vasculum. Vasculum is an instrument in which we collect it. It is made up of tin and it is bigger in size. Student, what they do, they collect all of their plant sample in vasculum so that they won't get dried up. But instead of taking vasculum, you can have polythene bags also, and in polythene bags you can carry them so that they won't get wilted so soon. Before we preserve them, they should not get wilted. So we will put them all in polythene bags. So after keeping them in polythene bags, what you are doing, you are returning at home and in your laboratory, and where you will have to have some particular things, like you will have to have blotting papers or tissue papers on which you are going to dry all these plants. And there is an equipment that is known as plant press. What plant press is? Plant press is basically made up of, these are two wooden platform. In between them you will have to place tissue paper and or blotting paper. On tissue paper you will have to place the plant sample. I will show you how you how you are going to do it. So for example, these are the blotting paper, and this is first portion of the plant press. You are keeping the plant sample of tulsi on it in such a way. And then you will be putting the another blotting paper on it. Why we are using blotting paper? So that it will absorb all the extra moisture from it. Then with the help of another notebook or another hard surface, we will press it. So this is the work that plant press does. So you will have to press it like this. And in every 2 to 3 days, you will need to change the blotting paper from it so that it won't get infected with the microorganism, it won't get fungus in it, and it won't get any awful smell in it. After changing it again and again, after 4 to 5 weeks, your plant sample will be ready if it is if the weather is summery. But if the weather is not summery, if there is moisture in the or humidity in the atmosphere, it will take at least 6 to 7 weeks to dry up completely. After drying them completely, what we'll have to do, we'll be requiring a herbarium sheet on which we need to paste it with the help of glue. Some student, what they do, they paste it with the help of the tape, cello tape, but it is not a correct way. What you will have to do, you will have to paste it with the help of gum only, and you will pasting it on the herbarium sheet with the help of gum. After that, you will have to mention all the things, all the details which has been asked by you, asked from you, like what is the name of collector, on which date you have collected it, and what was the locality from where you have collected the sample, and the classification of the plant. Like here I have collected tulsi, it belongs to family Labiatae. So you will have to mention all these details, their vernacular name, their botanical name, and their classification. And after keeping this thing in record, you will be preparing all the samples, all the herbarium sheets. After preparing herbarium sheet, you will have to place them on one another. And now you are not going to pressing them anymore, because they are so fragile and delicate that they can break down. So you will have to take care of them after pasting it on the herbarium sheet. In such a way, you can make a herbarium by seeing the herbarium, by collecting the plant from the normal natural place. You will get to know many characters about it, and you will get a lot of information about it. So it is a very important tool to study the botanical plant in their natural habitat. And if you can't find them in natural habitat, you can see the herbarium sheet, and you can get to know how the leaf look like, how the inflorescence look like of this particular plant. So in such a way, herbaria is very important. We have many important herbaria in our country as well as internationally. One more thing, the size of the herbarium sheet, what is the standard size of the herbarium sheet? And that is 28.75 centimeter multiplied by 41.25 centimeter. This is the standard size of the herbarium sheet. You will have to take the herbarium sheet of this size only. And at the side of the sheet, the details that I just mentioned are written, and you will have to follow that. So I hope this video was helpful for you about the herbarium. If you want to know any other thing about the herbarium, kindly comment below in our comment section. Please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.